Hello, my beautiful love goods, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are building another tiny house, and this one is considered a micro house, so I feel kind of proud of myself for that. But anyway, I am actually taking a viewer suggestion. I've actually been kind of wanting to build something like this for a while, and then I totally forgot your username. I'll look it up really quickly before I forget. Oh no, everything's crashing and burning. But yes, someone recommended that I build a fisherman's cottage in Brindleton Bay, and that is Jacinta. I hope I'm saying your name right, but yeah, I really liked that idea, and I was like, I've been wanting to do this for a while, so why not? So I made it into sort of a little A-frame cottage, and I'm building this on a 20 by 20 lot in Brindleton Bay. It's where the Bedlington Boathouse is. It's nice and cozy and warm and just, I don't know. I just really, really like how it looks in the end. But I am using a little bit of CC here as well. I am using mainly the Pufferhead stuff pack, as well as the content made by the Plumbob Tea Society, which is the Cottage Garden and the Rustic Romance stuff packs that they have. So definitely recommend checking out those three packs. They're really like beautifully maxis match sets, and they work so well with the game, so definitely recommend checking that out. But and I'll be sure to leave links in the description down below, if I can remember, to that content. So yeah, but anyway, as you can see, it's gonna be just a one bedroom house. It's really gonna be just for one sim. I can imagine there is like a fisherman that lives here, and he is, you know, just, you know, he does his fishing things, and then he just lives here by himself. And you know, maybe eventually he will meet someone, and maybe he'll meet a nice man, and you know, have like a happy, you know, like maybe he'll have some cats or something. I don't know. That's a dream, right? that's kind of a dream. But yeah, it's just a nice little cozy one, and I really love it. It's so nice. I used some stuff from the Get Together expansion pack. I think that it just looked really nice for a change. Like, I haven't used this stuff for a while, and I don't know, it was speaking to me. I've been really into this like more rustic, cottagey kind of style lately, and I love it so much. I think partially that has to do with the fact that I'm playing The Sims 3 again, but also Dragon Age Origins. I haven't played it in a few days, but I've really been inspired lately by that, because I don't know, it's nice. But that's something that I'm like trying to do, is find inspiration with my builds and other like forms, instead of just like, you know, instead of just going on like Pinterest and something or something and just like finding a random picture that I like. I would much rather prefer. What is that? What is English? But I really enjoy going to other sources, you know, such as, you know, other video games, YouTube videos, not directly themed around like a house, just more like everyday, like vlogs and stuff are really good for that. So yeah, it was really, really fun, nice and cozy. So here's some of the CC that you're seeing me use. This is all from I think this stuff here is from the Cottage Garden set. There's like that little wheelbarrow and those like pathway, like log pieces, and also those little pots, those little terracotta pots are so cute. I love those. And that little like wash bin of lavender, I think that's what it is, that's really cute. And then the little lumps of wood, that's not what that is, but those little piles of wood that honestly love that. I think they actually, what they did with that was they actually took the like the logs, the piles of logs from the I don't know what it's called. It's like the little wood box thing from the Get Together expansion pack. Honestly, kind of should have used that. That makes a lot more sense, because it would fit perfectly with the style of this build, to be honest. But I didn't think about it in the moment. I don't know. That's just how I am sometimes. But yeah, it's a cute little cottage, and I had lots of fun with it. I would definitely live here. And the roofing, now, I will say, building around roofing like this is super annoying because it doesn't like clip or anything the way I do it, because like I do like separate pieces of like roof sections, and yeah, it's a little bit complicated and a little bit roundabout, but it makes it, it keeps it from clipping into the actual house, so it doesn't look like it's an A-frame at all. But I would very much like to experiment a little bit and see if I can like figure out how to do like lofted ceilings with this. But regardless of that, it is a bit annoying sometimes too, because the camera in The Sims 4 tends to jump up and down like crazy whenever you have the walls up and the roofing up. I have to build with my walls up too. I know somebody actually mentioned that in the past, but I have to see what it's going to look like completely with the walls up at all times when I'm building. There's like a few exceptions here and there, but I usually try to keep the walls up so I can actually see everything, see exactly how everything is. And that was my phone beeping because I probably have an email or something. Yes, I do. That's what it is. But yeah, it's nice. I used a lot of stuff that's just kind of throughout the packs. Realm of Magic came in handy really well for some reason. Like, I feel like if this wasn't like here in Brindleton Bay, it could easily be in another, you know, like maybe even like Glimmerbrook, is that what it's called? It would look really beautiful there too, I think. There's nothing overtly fisherman about this cottage, I would say. It kind of fits the vibe that I'm wanting to go for, because there's really not any like fisherman, like fishing supplies or anything. Like, I could have added a boat or something outside and all that, but I didn't really think about that. And I don't know, I just feel like it would be kind of weird to have a boat like near the house whenever the ocean's like right there. I don't know. It's not super fisherman heavy, let's say, but there is some like wall art that actually kind of implies it a bit. Basically there's like some stuff from the, I'm pretty sure, yeah, it's the Cottage Garden fan-made stuff pack. I said that so many times already today. But the Cottage Garden pack, it's got these like wall, you know, like paintings, and they almost look like illustrations from like textbooks or something. And it's just got like plants and flowers, and there's like fish and all sorts of stuff. It's really, really, really nice content, honestly. Definitely recommend it. I've had this content, you know, like in my game, not in my game for that long, but like I've been using that content on and off throughout like the past couple of years at this point, and it's never content that I could see myself getting rid of because it's so useful. And in combination with what we have in game, it works really, really well. And yeah, it's great. Love that CC. Love Plum Bob Tea Society, and also the creators of the Pufferhead stuff pack. Honestly, chef's kiss. It's great. I used the little side tables in this build. It just looked good. I think that honestly, what I would have done differently if I ever redo this build or something, what I want to do is I want to actually just change out that love seat for just like a couple of armchairs, like some squashy armchairs. I don't know. Just mismatching those, it would speak to me more, I guess. I don't know. I just thought of that, but yeah, it's very run-of-the-mill, very basic. It's very small. It's got a single bed in the bedroom, and it's got a tiny little kitchen, a little tiny bathroom, a little tiny living room. It's just enough space for your Sims to live, and it is pretty much fully functional. I didn't test it, but I've played the game enough to know at this point like whether or not something will work, and pretty much everything will. I mean, there's plenty of space. I mean, it's a micro house. It's only, I think, 28? Maybe 26. I'm going to say 28 just to give myself a little bit of room for error, but it's about 26 to 28 tiles on the, you know, the lot and everything. So, I mean, I could have easily added a few more blocks, but, you know, got to challenge myself a bit there. But yeah, it was really fun, and it is a tiny house residential lot. So yeah, it's perfect. But anyway, I hope you all are having a good week, good day. I am trying my hardest to keep my videos consistent, so I am going to start having myself a little bit of an upload schedule. I'm not going to tell you all what it is, because if I put it out there and then I don't follow it, I feel like I've failed miserably, and then I will cease to upload. That's just my chaotic like anxiety happening, so just being honest. But yeah, I'm going to try to keep somewhat of a schedule for at least a bit. It's not going to be permanent. I mean, it might change in the future, but I'm going to try to keep things fairly consistent. It's just, it's a learning curve sometimes, because I did take a little bit of a break in February. I did upload a few videos. Like, I literally uploaded 4 videos in the entire month of February. It's wild to think that, because that's usually how much I would try to upload in a week almost. So yeah, it was very, very good for me, I think. I really feel refreshed. I feel way more motivated. I feel like I've kind of reset my brain a little bit. I feel like building in The Sims 4, like, I feel like I'm not doing the same thing every day, so yeah, it's great. But here are the screenshots to the build. I hope you all enjoy it. And it is available on the gallery, I'm pretty sure. The link will be, not the link, the username is Lukey Dean, and you can also search the hashtag Lukey Lupin to find it. And yeah, that is pretty much it. I hope you all have a fantastic rest of your day and a fantastic rest of your week. And go drink some water and go eat something that makes you feel happy. Let's just do that, because I did today and I feel great. Anyway, thank you all so, so very much for watching. Stay weird and beware of the Nurgles.